In the next few minutes, I'm going to explain to you why search intent is the secret to superior keyword research. I'm going to give you a system that is going to help impact how your keyword research is conducted, how it is implemented into content, and I believe impact the results you're going to get from that keyword research. So let's dive in. First of all, what is search intent? Essentially, there are four categories of search intent. There is navigational searches, informational searches, commercial investigation, and transactional searches. Navigational searches are like someone searching for Twitter support or, looking up Facebook. Informational is who, what, when, where, how type searches. And commercial investigation is more like someone looking for unbiased reviews or maybe looking through Amazon reviews or Yelp. And lastly is transactional, and that's someone at the end of the buying cycle looking for free shipping or buy it now or, products near me. Let me give you a practical example of what I'm talking about as we walk through each of the steps you need to take. Step one is to Google your main keyword and analyze the results. This is usually like a head term. So I have Googled beard oil, as you can see here, because, SEO and beards, right? So once you've done that, you need to move to step two, which is to understand which search intent categories Google is displaying on that head search phrase. Another way of doing that is to simply click into the search box and look at what Google is showing. So you can see here they are displaying beard oil reviews, and that is what? Commercial investigation. You get a star. Beard oil growth, that's more in the informational how-to. And then here are your transactional, and you even could consider this navigational because they're trying to get somewhere specific on a specific site. So what does this tell us? This you will see play out on a lot of head terms. And a head term is essentially something very broad, not very specific. And Google doesn't actually know what your intent is. So it's kind of giving you a little bit of everything. And you'll notice that. It may be product focused. So here's some pricing, here's some products. There's advertising on the page. The first result, though, is informational. It's saying, what the heck is beard oil? How does it work? But the very second one is on, kind of an e-commerce site. So it's a little bit all over the map. And you'll notice that Google does this with a lot of head terms. That's going to lead us to step three. Step three is you now want to hone in on your results for the specific category that you're going to try to make content for and do keyword research for and optimize for. In this case, we're going to look at informational. So we're more interested of this article than we are of this product focused transactional content. So let's take a look at a more specific informational keyword. And here I have, what does beard oil do? Notice now there's no ads. The results are all, informational. There's a featured snippet here that's informational from that Huffington Post, that result that was ranking number one, it's the same one, but now they're displaying the information differently because search intent. None of this is complicated, but once you get this ingrained in how you do keyword research and how you match this up, it's going to make a massive difference. I'm looking at this. I see that, these informational searches are probably the way I want to go, and I want to kind of match up with what's out there right now that's doing well in the top 10 and top 20 on Google. Step four would be to use Answer the Public. It is a free keyword tool. If you are not familiar with it, you should check out my free keyword research video I did. I did a ton of free keyword tools. You can check that out. This is one of them. And I've put beard oil into Answer the Public. And essentially, it's going to show me all the questions and prepositions that are being asked around my head term, which is beard oil. this is where you're going to get a lot more of that informational intent. You know, who needs beard oil? How do you make it? What's it made out of? All that kind of stuff is in here. So what I want you to do is I want you to go up here and export this to a CSV. That is going to lead us to step 5, and we're going to analyze the keywords in bulk with another keyword tool, Keywords Everywhere. Keywords Everywhere is free. It's if you have a paid tool, go ahead and use that too. I'm just showing you some free options so you have them. So I just took all the prepositions and all the questions from Answer the Public, and then I pasted them into Keywords Everywhere, and here are my results. You can see one of the top searches is what does beard oil do? People are asking about growth, things like that. That's going to lead us into step 6, which is to create a keyword list that aligns, and this is key, that aligns exclusively with your search intent category. So beard oil near me, that's you know, a mobile search. It has nothing to do with your search intent that you're optimizing for. Also, like, you know, anything beard oil for sale, that's transactional. If it was the best beard oils, that is commercial investigation looking for reviews, right? So you're only going to focus and you're going to remove all of these keywords that are not informational. So don't try to do too much with one thing. Just hyper optimize on informational search intent, if that's what you're going for. Obviously, if you're going for reviews, then sure, go for that. So that would bring us to step 7. So what you're going to end up with is a list like this. These are the target keywords that I grabbed that are, you know, informational. You know, how do you do this? Why do you do this? How often should you do this? That kind of thing. I've removed all the things we just talked about, the research ones, the commercial ones, all that's gone. And so this is what we're left with that has traffic. Now, this is where everybody tends to make a mistake. They take this keyword list and they hand it off to their copywriters. It's not the worst thing in the world to do. You're giving them a lot of direction, but you're not gonna like the result you get, and I don't think Google will either. It's just human nature that they're going to try to like shoehorn in these keywords everywhere, and it just doesn't work out 99% of the time. So what you actually wanna do is step 7, use the remaining keywords to create a rough outline. So you can see here, I've done that. This is nothing groundbreaking. It's a very simple outline. I'm telling my editor, hey, we're going to do informative content. And instead of giving them keywords, I'm giving them the outline. So you can see that I'm saying, what is this? This section is going to be, what does beard oil actually do? And then I want you to kind of address why you would use it. What's it made out of? And then I'm going to have a section on how to apply it. How often, how much, how long is this gonna last me? And again, these are all from the keywords, but I'm presenting it to the editor so that it's much more about just answering those questions and intent that the searchers have. And I'm gonna try to make kind of one great resource that Google could look at and go, wow, if I send people here and they are in the information stage and they're gathering information, this would be an amazing resource because it hits on everything, because Google knows what they're searching too. Now you do, and you can match it to your content. So I have this whole list out, and then down at the bottom, you'll notice that I have the content and video suggestions. So that would bring us to step 8. You want to get the average content length of the top 10 results to kind of approximate the depth of your content. You don't need to be so specific. Like, I used SEMrush and looked at the top 10. That they said that was an average. They had about 1,200, 1,300 words. Don't get too caught up on it. Just use it as an approximation. If you don't have a premium tool like SEMrush or something like that, Hrefs, you could literally just visit each of those pages, copy out the body content, and paste that into a Google Doc and collect all that and then get your average that way for free. This brings us to step 9, which is to literally hand the outline, not the keyword list. Don't even let them see it. Hand the outline to your editor. You're going to get much better content back, and they're going to be writing for the user and not for keywords. Step 10, make slight optimization changes, before you publish. Tweak that a little bit, sure. Make sure that it's nailing everything that you want, but do it at that stage and you're gonna have much better content. I promise if you implement this and you just start thinking about it, like, okay, wait a minute, this article straying into transactional, it really shouldn't. Now, could you have a CTA in this for, you know, a free trial of your beard oil if that was the case? Sure. But in general, just don't try to mix them up too much. If you want to have one that's a review, then go all out on that. Have a staffer review, you know, 10 beard oils and give their take on it and that kind of thing. Hopefully this video kind of gets you thinking in this mindset. And I really believe that it will help your end result. I know it has helped mine. Hit me up down in the comments. I'm very active. Users try to respond to every single one. Subscribe, like, all those things. And I'll see you in the next video.